What's up, everybody? FNR Kennels over here. Just want to give you guys a quick update of the Chopper. Hey, Chopper and Cookie Litter, they're in there together again. I got them back together. They like to be together. Be careful on how you guys pair up your dogs. And I know a lot of people do it. And stop. A lot of people do in the winter. I like to do it too. I do it with Chopper and Cookie. They get along real good ever since they got here together. You know, almost. Cookie got here a little bit later than Chopper did, but they got along really good because Chopper was still a pup when she was a pup. So they go well together. They don't fight. They share the food. Now just be careful because even though you can put a female and a male. They not all the time they're gonna be all right, you know. I tried putting a Candy here with Chopper when Cookie was pregnant of the puppies, and it didn't go so good. It just Candy would take all the food, and you know she just wouldn't let Chopper get near the feeding bowl. So I just decided to put her back by herself, and then Chopper was by himself, and then Cookie was just they were all by themselves when Cookie was pregnant. But now that she's not, or she's done whelping, she's back with Chopper. I might put her in this kennel. That's where I was keeping the puppies at, but I sold them all. That's the reason of this video. I just want to keep you guys updated. All the puppies are gone. They're sold. I sold the last one yesterday, actually. I was going to make a video on that puppy remaining today, but she was going to sell regardless, like really quick, because when the litter dropped, I posted them up once. And they all sold, and she was the first one that was taken, and everybody kept asking for that puppy, the last one that I sold, that was the one that everybody was asking about. But she was taken at the moment when people were hitting me up for puppies. So the guy ended up losing his job, and he didn't want to get it. So there was no biggie, you know. I knew she was gonna sell anyway, so yeah, as soon as I opened her up back to sell, some guy hit me up out of nowhere. Actually, somebody here, local, came and picked her up. And all the puppies went to good homes. I mean, the furthest one that I sold was to Nevada. The guy came down, picked them up. Real decent people. They seem like they like the breed. They want to learn about it. They all got my contact. But yeah, they all sold. I'm sorry I didn't make that many videos about the puppies. I just don't have enough time, you know. Like I said, I don't really depend off of YouTube or even to sell my dogs. Like I don't go off of YouTube that much. I know there were a couple people off of YouTube that hit me up about the pups. When they did, they were already sold out. They were already picked and everything. So that's why I couldn't really get back to those people. But I did let them know that if one of those pups were opened up, that I was going to let them know. But, I mean, they really didn't. But, yeah, overall, I think, you know, this year, you know, was a breeding for me. My first breeding, my first litter, everything went good. The AI went good. Both dogs did fantastic. Chopper and Cookie. Cookie, she whelped phenomenal. She was a good mother. Really nice puppies. They were all, you know, straight tails, full tails, all of them straight backs. They were nice dogs, nice puppies. Everybody was happy with their puppy that they got, and I was happy to find my puppies a good home. That's why my puppies, you know, I don't think, you know, they're for the first breeding, I think I did all right. I was selling them between 500 to 600. They all went Two of them went for 600, and then the rest went for like 500, and then one of them was like 550. Real cheap. I think that's what helped me sell my puppies really fast. Cause for bullies, you know, Chopper, hey, Cookie. So yeah, for pocket bullies, you can't get no cheaper than that, you know. And I went through ABR, so they're registered. I wasn't gonna register any of my dogs, but I figure, you know, since I'm a decent dude, I try to be honest with my dogs. And I felt like it was just something not necessary, but something extra that you could do for the customer, which was, you know, have their paperwork in order. You don't have to. I mean, like I said, to me, they're dogs, and I love dogs. I'm a dog man. I don't like cats, but I like the dogs. So, I don't care, you know. I didn't care for my dogs, you know. But I mean, on paperwork, that kind of didn't came out wrong. That came out wrong, you know. I don't care for my dogs. Don't do that. But like what I'm saying, I didn't care for my dogs' paperwork. They all have their paperwork. But I wasn't gonna do registered litters because I knew I was gonna sell them cheap anyways. But I ended up doing it anyways. I mean, I think it costed like $80, I think, 80 or 60 to go with ABR to just register the litter. So that's what I did. All the customers were happy about it. So I think I'm just gonna register. I wasn't gonna do it at the beginning, you know. This channel was just more like, I guess on the easier side of breeding dogs for a hobby, you know, that's what this channel was intended for. But I mean, I think I'll just register it just because I think it's something extra nice that you could do for the customer, not really to benefit so much of the money, because either way I ended up selling them for the same price. It's not like I raised up the price just because of it, because the dogs that I bred could easily sold for $1,000 or $1,200, you know, maybe more, because damn, there were the run of the litter, which was a female. She was really looking real nice. She was short and she had a blocky head. She was probably like the one with the blocky ass head. And then there was the biggest female, which was the one I just sold, the last one that I sold that everybody kept asking for. She was the nicest one out of like the whole litter. She was real thick, really nice coat, nice coat. She had like the best coat out of all the pups, maybe because she was the biggest one. Maybe that made her look a little bit better. But and then there was the second male. That guy, that was the one I wanted to keep, but I just ended up selling because I think I'm just gonna get another pup off somebody else's yard, and that way I could start my bloodline like that, or you know, breed that one. I wanted to breed that one with Candy, the one, because I want to get another pie ball. Candy, she's somewhat of a pie ball. So I want to get another male that's a pie ball, so I could have pie ball puppies with Candy, and then I could have those browns, lilacs, and fawns with Chopo and Cookie. And they even carry the tribe, but I don't really care so much about the tribe. I really like pie balls, and I really like fawns and lilacs, and Chopo. I just, you know, he's a brown, but I knew Cookie was gonna bring out those colors, so that's why I kept them together, you know. But but Candy, I want some pie balls out of Candy, some pie balls. So I need to get a pie ball, which I'm already working a deal with the guy, actually here local too. So hopefully it goes through and I get a pie ball, or somewhere around there where I could bring out pie balls. But yeah, so yeah, I just want to keep you guys updated on it. As far as right now, the next step for the kennels, for the FNR kennel. I don't know. I mean, I'm probably gonna wait till summer cools down, and I'm gonna start building them. I'm gonna build them a porch out here, like a patio, you know, over the, that way I could get rid of these tarps up here, and that plywood that's giving them shade. It works, but I just want to have something more. I want to have something that looks a little bit nicer. So that's the plan, but I'll have to probably wait till like the end of the summer. I don't know, I'll probably start building in like in October or so. Another thing, I probably might get another kennel, because I just want to have enough kennels where they reach this back wall, where this back wall ends. You see that? That way it doesn't interfere with the neighbor, and I don't want that many, you know, smells or anything like that going to the neighbor's house. Just to be a good neighbor. They're really nice people, so I don't like to mess with them. They keep an eye out here for my dogs, make sure they don't get stolen. They're really nice neighbors. These neighbors back here and my neighbor back here, he's retired, so it's like he's always watching my dogs. So it's like I always have somebody watching my dogs, which is nice. But that's the plan for that right now. And if I do get the other male that comes through, he won't be ready till like about another like 10 weeks or 8 weeks. So, I mean, if I do get them, I'll make sure I do a video of them so you guys could meet them. You guys could check them out and see how it looks. Give me your opinion if I made a right choice or if I did not. That doesn't matter though, because I'm buying it, not you guys. But I always like to see what people think, you know, because it's nice to get other people's opinions, even though you might not go with them. But it's always nice just to see what other people think, because you never know. It's going to be those people, those same people that could probably buy a dog or puppy from you later on in the future. So, I mean, like they say, the customer's always right. But Yeah, it is what it is. I just want to give you guys a quick update. Right before I clean up this kennels, I'm going to desanitize them because this is where the puppies were. So I just want to make sure everything's fresh just in case I do put Cookie back here. And I always kept my stuff sanitized. I try to do it, you know, every 2 weeks, sanitize them. Clean them every day, but you try to sanitize. Well, at least I do. I try to sanitize every 2 weeks. And then this stuff works. So I know, but I'm pretty sure everybody uses it, but Bronco, it works. Keeps the flies off of them, you know. Spray them in the back of the ears, help them too. Just make sure you don't get it in their eyes, mouth, and everything should be good. But yeah, there's Candy right there. She's looking great. She's gonna bring out some beautiful puppies, man. I just gotta make sure, if I don't run her to, I gotta run her to Chapo just to make sure I consist this height. You see that? She ain't gonna get no taller, you know. And Chapo, he's done growing. So as long as I stay in that height, that's my pockets. That's what I don't want to go anything lower than that too, because I don't want to run into no C-section problems. So I'll keep you guys posted on what I do. But as far as right now, those are the stuff that I want to do. So I try to make videos off of it. Oh, another thing I might do before I even get the other kennel, switch this to floors, to wooden floors, or maybe do wooden. I want to do wooden floors and pavers, half wooden floor, you know. They could lay on the wood, and they could, like, the pavers will help with their nails, so they could trim them down a little bit, wear them out. And I want to do that with this kennel too. And then I'll just keep this one wood until it's time to change it. Then once this one's time to get switched out, I'll do half wood and half pavers as well. But and that's the plan. I mean, that's FNR kennels, you know. Out. I'll keep you guys posted with whatever. And all the puppies are sold, so I'm sorry. I'll try to, next time I have a breeding, you know, this year coming up, I'll probably have two breedings, two litters. So I'll try to make more videos of puppies, because I know a lot of people, they just like watching puppies. They don't care about buying one or anything like that. But I mean, even myself, I like watching American Bully Puppies videos and stuff like that. But yeah, I'll keep you guys posted. And you know, maintain, if you guys got dogs outside like I do, make sure you maintain them cool, coming out here and wet them. I set up some of these things, some misters, and then I also have one running across the kennels. I know it ain't the best setup, but it's what I could do right now at the time, and just keep your dogs healthy, and I'll let you guys know. Thank you.